Till now we have seen equal and annual worth comparison, and we solved different problems from it, right? So now we will see, I mean, you would have solved the problems that comes under all these cases. So we will see what are the different situations or cases in which we normally use equivalent annual worth comparison. Okay, first is consolidation of cash flows. Second is recovery of invested capital. Third is net cash flow comparison. Okay, so what do you mean by consolidation of cash flows? That is, there are certain scenarios in which we need to make certain changes in the spending of the cash, or we need to make certain changes in our department or organization, and for that we need to spend some amount and we need to check the return. So we will see if the return is positive or not. If the return is positive, then we can say that making this change is worth. So that is what our conclusion is. So that is what we'll be seeing here in consolidation of cash flows. Okay, so that answers basically what is its worth, whether it is worth to do this process. Okay, that is what we'll be checking in the first case. So you please solve this problem. This problem says whether a consulting firm need to spend so much amount of money in self-inspection. Okay, so that it may improve the consulting firm's operations. So whether it need to spend this much amount in this process or not is what we need to find out. So what you have to do is you have to find the equivalent annuity for the given data here and see if the annuity that we are getting here is positive or not. Okay, if it is positive, then we can say, so you will get three scenarios: positive, zero, negative. Positive means yes, it is worth to implement this process. Negative means there is a deficit in the or there is a loss in whatever we are trying to implement, so we will not consider it. Zero means there is no difference, that is the change won't make much difference in the cost. In that case, the other certain other factors will come into picture to consider whether we need to propose a change or not. That is the first case. Next case is recovery of invested capital. So what do you mean by this? This means will whatever we are trying to invest pay off. Okay, so this is basically what we are trying to find is capital recovery cost. That is, we are investing some amount and the return what we get, will it pay off? That is what we need to find out. So again, we will see the revenue here. We will see the disbursements, we will see the receipts, and we will see what the revenue that we are getting. If the revenue that we are getting is positive, then yes, it is worth investing in this. Otherwise, if it is negative or zero, then we need to again reconsider. If negative means we will not consider this option, or zero means we will see what are the other factors. Okay, so this is what is recovery of invested capital. So these two problems, I want you to pause the video and solve this problem and this problem, and find out what is the answer. Post it in the Slack. Okay. Excuse me. And now coming to the third part, that is net cash flow comparison. We have seen throughout the problems that we solved, the 10 problems that we solved, you have seen one or the other variation of this net cash flow comparison, where what are we trying to answer here? Which one is better? We have different options given here. Which one do we need to prefer? Which is the preferred way? So different options, what do? we will find out what is the equivalent annual worth of different options that we have, and we will see which is having the highest or which is giving them profit, or which is in certain cases which has the least expenditure. Depends on the question, we will find out and we will decide which one is better. Okay, so you have solved so many problems in this, so I'm not giving any more problems from this. Okay, next coming to the next one, that is next part is asset life. What do you mean by asset life? So asset life is nothing but, see, we have seen the in general, in case of annuity, what is the asset life that we consider? From the time an asset is purchased to the time we dispose it, that is what the asset life that we are considering. So there are definitions for asset lives. There are three cases here. Okay, first is ownership life, then accounting life and economic life. Okay, so what do you mean by ownership life or service life? It is nothing but the period of an asset in which it is kept in service by the owner. Okay, that means useful service time from the period it is purchased to the time it is disposed. That is what is service life or ownership life. That is a useful time of the asset. Okay, next is accounting life. Accounting life is nothing but the expectancy, life expectancy of the asset. That is what is accounting life. Okay, now it is basically used for bookkeeping or for, again, tax consideration, all that we consider accounting life. Next is economic life. So it is the time period that we consider that minimizes the asset's equivalent cost and maximizes the income. That is what is economic life. That means it is the period in which it was most profitable. After that, we will consider different alternatives, whether to replace. We will consider the case scenarios where do we need to find an alternative for this machine or asset. We will consider. Okay, so this is what is asset life. Now coming to asset life, in the previous module 2, we have seen that assets, what we are considering, different alternatives that we are considering, can have equal life or unequal life. So equal life we have seen, I think, in the most of the problems that you have solved till now has equal life. Yes, I think one or two problems has unequal lives. So equal life, what do we do? We will see that two assets has same lifespan from the time we start using it to the time it is disposed, same lifespan. Whereas unequal life, one asset is having say 4 years, another asset is having 2 years. So how do we consider, how do we compare? We know that one of the basis for comparison of asset is lifespan, and we consider it as equal. So what do we do if asset is having unequal life? Then there are two scenarios that we considered in the previous module, that is, in which one is repeated project assumption. Okay, I'm talking about assets with unequal life. So what is the scenario that we consider for assets for unequal life? In case of unequal lives, we consider a repeated project assumption here. Okay, in case of equivalent annual worth comparison, we use repeated projects assumption. Why? Because what we are trying to consider here is, if asset 1 is having say 4 years of life expectancy and asset 2 is having 8 years of expectancy, then our assumption is asset 1 will be purchased two times in a span of 8 years. Okay, what is it? So, asset 1 has 4 years life expectancy and asset 2 has 8 years. So, what do we do? Here, asset 1 will be purchased twice. Okay, asset 1 will be purchased twice in a span of 8 years. Okay, so that is what we consider. And what do we do? We will, so what is the case that we have? We will see the annuity for 4 years. In asset 1's case, we will see the annuity for 4 years. And that will be repeated for the next 4 years. That is what we are considering. So, first 4 years, whatever is the annuity, it will be repeated in the next 4 years. Also, when the asset is purchased for the second time. Okay. So, what do? We will find the annuity. In this case, we will find the annuity for the first 4 years. It will be repeated for the next 4 years for 8 years. We will see. It will remain the same for the next 4 years also. And we will compare it with asset 2 that has 8 years of life expectancy, its annuity. And we will take a decision. Okay. That is what we will be doing. I hope the concept is clear. So, if the concept is clear, I want you people to solve this question. This is having assets with different lifespan. Okay. So, third case, coming to the third case. Third case, I hope you remember, perpetual life. Say dams or certain buildings. It has perpetual life. What do you mean by perpetual life? Perpetual life means the life expectancy, we are considering it as infinity. So, in that case, how do we calculate? So, it is A given P, I, N. So, this is the formula for a given P for I and N. Okay. Whereas here, what do we have? Here, N is infinity. Perpetual life means infinite lives. Infinite life. So, N is infinity. In that case, N approaches infinity, we will get our A given P as I. I means that means the capital recovery factor will be interest rate itself. Okay, that is what it is. I hope this concept is clear. In case where I is if N is infinity, then A given P will have a value of interest rate itself. That is what it is. Next, coming to the next part, that is sinking fund. What do you mean by sinking fund? Sinking fund is not there in your syllabus. So, sorry. Okay, now coming to the next part. That is, what happens if interest rate varies for some time period? Okay, if interest rate varies for some time period, you can see this question here. So, if interest rate is varying, then what we consider is, for that time period, what is the interest rate? Okay, so in this question, you can see first year it is 6%, then every year it will increase for 1%. Then 6% for 1 year, it is 6%. So we will calculate F given P. Then for this year, again F given P for the new interest rate. Then next year, again F given P for new interest rate. Next year, again F given P for new interest rate. Like that, we will get a future value for first year, second year, third year and fourth year, based on which we calculate the annuity. That is what we will be doing. Now, we will get a future amount at first year, future amount at second year, third year, fourth year, for which we find the annuity. Okay. So, this is what module 3's first part, that is annual equivalent worth comparison. So, we are done with annual equivalent worth comparison. Next, we need to find out the rate of return. So that we'll see in the next module. Thank you.